To the Philippine Benchmark Index now. Philippine shares begin the new trading week in the green. The main index gaining 0.6% to close at 66.89. Value turnover, meanwhile, was at 5.2 billion pesos. Ron Acoba of Trading Edge now joins us for some market analysis. Hi, Ron. Welcome again to the Business Roadshow.
Hi, Stanley. Good afternoon.
All right, let's talk about the U.S. first. What's your view on the U.S. political developments, particularly the assassination attempt on former President Donald Trump? Has it affected other markets, as you saw?
Well, fortunately, from a market perspective, former President Donald Trump was able to survive the recent assassination attempt on his life. Obviously, worst case is that, of course, if he didn't, such an event would trigger a lot of political unrest in the U.S., which in theory would obviously trigger more volatility across the global market. So as of now, I mean, just looking at how the Philippine local stock exchange perform, it appears that the market is somewhat discounting what has happened over the past weekend.
Okay, that is, of course, for the assassination attempt. But what about the general economy in the U.S., the climate there? How do you make sense of perhaps the unstable political landscape, which may induce inflation or even cast economic uncertainties and poor sentiments for U.S. markets? Will this affect the rate-cutting timelines by the Fed? What are you seeing?
Well, the race between Trump and Biden for the presidency has obviously heated up to the point that there was already an assassination attempt on former President Trump. So far, though, the Fed has maintained its independence from both politics and even from the fiscal policies of the government, keeping inflation and the jobs data as their key drivers in relation to their monetary policy. As of today, the market is pricing in a 90% probability of the Fed cutting rates as early as September ahead of the November inflation. So far, in terms of both monetary policy and in terms of sentiment, it appears that these two are still geared towards inflation and monetary policy rather than any volatility stemming from the political landscape.
Yes, Ron, perhaps that kind of volatility, you know, 90% by September or so for the U.S. Federal Reserve would, of course, bode well with our own rate-cutting path, which is perhaps one of the reasons why we did well today at 66.89. Yeah. That's quite a finish. Yeah. That's quite a salvo to 3 weeks of more or less gains for this market.
Well, as of today, yes, obviously, the PSEI at one point today was up actually by 1.3% and ended up nonetheless by 0.6%, totally ignoring the boiling political landscape, especially what has happened over the past weekend. Over the past 3 to 4 weeks, though, the index is actually up, 7 to 8%. So, and the main driver is actually the dovishness stemming from the recent slowdown in inflation rate and the dovish tone by Fed Chairman Powell. So all of these things are triggering investors to look ahead and position ahead of the likely cut in interest rates in the next 2 months.
And Ron, in the next couple of days, it will be characterized by, of course, inflation talk and still hints about the rate-cutting path of the Federal Reserve. What does that mean now for Philippine investors? What do we watch out for? What cues, perhaps, would you like to see from Fed Chair Jerome Powell's speeches?
Well, obviously, the main driver of a change, if any, in monetary policy would obviously remain to be the direction of inflation. So fortunately, inflation over the last 3 months, at least in the U.S., has improved down to 3% from a high of 3.5% in March, marking a third consecutive month of slowdown. And this is what the Fed is actually wanting to see for them to consider starting rates. If you recall, looking back, the Fed actually noted that it's looking actually to see a trend in a slowdown in inflation, not just 1 or 2 months worth of data. So for the coming month, it is actually imperative to perhaps see that U.S. domestic inflation improve further to sub 3%. This would actually validate the likelihood of a Fed cut in September. Obviously, okay. Obviously, other markets are just benchmark against what the monetary policy of the U.S. is. So if the U.S. is finally showing that it's already starting to pivot from its currently tight monetary policy, then perhaps the BSP and even the other central banks would also do the same.
Okay, Ron, I'd like to talk about BSP and Philippine inflation now. Over the weekend, you know, the latest Pulse Asia survey came out reflecting the priorities top of mind of most Filipinos. Yeah. Survey, that's about more than 60% saying government has to still prove its ability to bring down inflation. Now, interesting to note that respondents' perceptions see no change in their economic circumstances, even as economic managers are reporting significant drops in CPI. How do you make sense of that?
Because there's a disconnect between what the respondents are seeing and what the numbers are actually giving. Case in point, inflation actually measures the change in the price of goods and services relative to last year's prices. Now, if you say from an economist point of view that inflation relative to last year prices has already decreased by 1-3%, which is in fact it didn't. It rose by 3.7%, which is actually still high. But nonetheless, even if you say for the sake of argument that it's actually up 1% relative to last year's prices, now if you ask me, a normal person, I'd say prices are still high.
Yeah.
Diba? Yeah. Prices are still high, especially relative to pre-pandemic levels, relative to 2019. Diba? It was only 2021 where prices have started to surge. It started with food, with rice, with tubers, with onions, with garlic, etc., with oil, and now recently rice. So if you ask a normal citizen relative to what they remember, like a couple of years back, prices are still essentially high. So over the past three years, while inflation has slowed down relative to last year, relative to a 4 years time frame, it's actually surged by quite a lot. And that is why from the respondent's point of view, it is imperative for the government to still prioritize inflation.
All right, Ron, let's talk about markets now. Investment houses have upgraded to 8,180 from 8,142. The potential PSEI finish for a 12-month basis from an average closing, of course, it's based on that computation, at 6,400 that was computed last week, if I understand correctly.
Yeah.
Now, a possible upside is now pegged at 25.99, it's almost 26% for the year. Is this cognizant now of better times for the markets?
Well, hopefully. Well, obviously, institutions are pricing in a likely upside re-rating for the next year or so, driven firstly by the index's current cheap valuation relative to how it was doing pre-pandemic and relative to its peers in the region. Obviously, corporate earnings, despite the higher input cost, remain to be robust. First quarter and likely second quarter's earnings will likely continue to be to see double-digit growth, and obviously, and more importantly, for the months ahead, the likely decrease in interest rates. These are the ones that will likely drive valuations, market levels to reach the 8,000 level. Hopefully, 12 months down the road.
Hopefully. Now, lastly, Ron, with eyes on the PSE's improving performance, of course, the question really is. Is now a good time for accumulation? Because months back, analysts were looking at levels as low as 5,700 for the market to really initiate a re-entry. I mean, for investors to start trading this market again. Does it still make sense now to wait for that level?
Well, for me, it doesn't really make sense in a wait for a 5.7 level and more. In fact, any weakness in the short run, no matter how shallow or deep it is, should be taken as a window to accumulate stocks. And in my opinion, particularly on cyclicals like banks and properties and even gold stocks. Why? Because these will be the ones to immediately benefit if and when we finally see a decrease in interest rates. So we're nearing that. Previously, we've been talking about a likely cut in interest rates, which is what, 6 months down the road. Mm. Now we're just waiting for 2 months. So konting hintay na lang.
All right. Ron Acoba, again, thank you so much for joining us this afternoon, for sharing with us your thoughts about this market. Have a great day.
Thank you, Stanley. Thank you for having me again.